There was a time when we used to write letters to our dear ones to know how they are doing and to let them know about us. There was a time when we used to love the red post boxes and we used to eagerly wait for the inland letters which are blue in color and the letters in cars which used to bring us good news about admissions, about jobs and about so many other things. With the advent of technology these days, however, sending letters by post has taken a back seat. With dozens of communication technologies and social media to choose from, we don't resort to letters today to communicate our messages or to convey something to our dear ones. However, the style of communicating through letters still persists in the form of emails. And in today's session, we are going to look at some of the nuances of letter writing. We will look at the types of letters, the format in which these letters are to be written, and also some of the important points to keep in mind while we are writing the letters. So we'll look at the type of letters, the format in which these letters are to be written, and some facts or some points to keep in mind that will help us to communicate effectively through these letters. As we all might know, letters basically fall under two categories. They are the formal ones and the informal ones. Formal letter, informal letter. The informal letters are also known as personal letters. These are letters that we write to our friends, to our parents, to our dear ones, basically to anyone whom we share a personal relationship with. And due to the personal nature of these letters, they are more relaxed and we generally use a very casual or an emotional tone while writing these letters. They are more relaxed and we use a casual or emotional tone while writing these letters. In the case of formal letters, they are written for business or for professional purpose with a specific objective in mind. They are written for business or for professional purpose. With a specific objective in mind. Since they are written for business or for professional purposes, they generally adopt a very serious tone. A variety of letters fall under the category of formal letters. They are business letters. We have so many that fall under the category of formal letters. They are business letters. Employment letters, covering letters, circular letters. All these letters come under the category of formal letters and they are generally written very short and to the point. They are very precise, directly addressing the concerned issue. So both of them are written in two different styles. As we already saw, the informal letters, due to its personal nature, are very relaxed and they adopt a very casual or an emotional tone, and we don't adhere to very strict principles when it comes to informal letter. Whereas in the case of formal letter, due to the business or the professional purpose for which it is written, it adopts a very serious tone. It is written in simple language so that it can communicate to the receiver. And there are different types of formal letters, and it is written very short and precise. So now we will look at the format of these two letters, these two type of letters. To look at the format of a formal letter has 8 essential components. We will look at each one of them in detail. The first component of a formal letter is the sender's address, and the sender's address is also known as the return address. This is the mailing address of the sender, of the person who is sending the letter. It is known as return address because this is the address to which a reply or a return for this letter will come. So this is the first component where we'll be giving our name, our designation, our address, etc. And the only one case where we can omit the sender's address is if you are writing a letter on your letterhead. If you are writing it on a letterhead that already contains the details, you can omit this part. Otherwise, this is a very essential component in a formal letter. And the second element is the date. We generally follow the DDMMYY, the alphanumeric pattern, to write the date. However, the MMDDYY, that is the month, date and the year pattern, is also acceptable. And then we write the receiver's address. The receiver's address is the address of the recipient, the one who receives the letter. And there you start with the name of the person, then you will give the designation of the person to whom you are writing the letter. His or her official address is what we generally use in the receiver's address part. So we have the sender's address, the date, and the receiver's address, and then we come to the subject. We write the subject line very briefly. A maximum of 6 to 8 words will be used, and it tells the, or it helps the reader to understand the aim of the letter or the purpose of the letter in a glance. By looking at the subject line in a letter, we can understand what is the purpose of this letter. So it has to be very precise and very clear, and it cannot go long. So the subject line will always be preceded with this word subject. We'll write subject, we'll put a colon, and then we'll very precisely write the subject of the letter. And then comes the salutation, which is the customary greeting. And we greet the person to whom we are writing the letter, and we proceed to the body of the letter. So for salutation, if we know the name of the person, we can actually use that. We use dear or respected before the name, dear Mr. whatever name that we have in hand. So we can use it that way. And if we do not really know the name of the person, if you are addressing a person in a position and if you do not know their name, you can write it as dear Mr. President or respected President or so. So if you know the name, you can use it there for the salutation. If you do not know that, you can use their designation to salute them, to greet them. The next part is the most important part of the letter, that is the body of the letter. Though we give all the details as part of the format of the letter, the most important part of the letter is the body, which will communicate your message, which communicate the purpose of the letter to the recipient. The body of the letter can be divided into three parts. The first one is the introduction, then the main content, and then we end by summarizing the main points. The introduction states the purpose of the letter. We introduce our concern to the reader, and the introduction should always be an interesting one. It should capture the reader. They should feel like reading the rest of the letter after reading your introduction. So it should be very appealing to the reader, and then we go to the main content, which will state the facts very precisely and in simple language so that everything is communicated to the reader. And in the last part, we'll summarize the main points that we already presented. And so the body of the letter comprises of these three parts, and through this part we communicate and we convey our message. So once after conveying our message through the body of the letter, we are ready to close the letter, and we have to end the letter in a very polite manner. So we use a complimentary close, which is generally we use it as yours truly or yours sincerely, yours respectfully, are the normal complimentary closes that we use. So we close the letter that way, and we end the formal letter with the signature line, which will generally include the signature of the person, the name of the person, and the designation if it is necessary. So the signature line can have the sign, the name, and designation if necessary. So these are the 8 components of formal letter. And now, with the advent of technology, since we mostly type all the letters than writing them these days, we follow the left alignment pattern. That is, all these are aligned to the left side of the paper. That is what we mostly follow these days. We start with the sender's address, that is left aligned, and then after leaving a space, we have the date in the alphanumeric format, and after the date, after a space, we have the receiver's address, again left aligned, and then we have the subject line and the salutation, the body, the complimentary close, and the signature. So this is how we write a formal letter. And now to look at the informal letter. As I already mentioned before, the informal letter, due to its personal touch and its casual and relaxed nature, does not really follow this stricter pattern. This is for a business purpose, for a professional purpose, and we cannot take anything for granted here. We have to be very clear and specific about each and every element here. But when it comes to the informal letter, we don't generally have these many contents in that. So in informal letters, we have the sender's address to begin with. There are cases when we don't write the sender's address as part of the letter, but when we are looking at the format of informal letter, sender's address is a part of it. So we have to start with the sender's address, which again is a return address here also. But the only difference is that since we are writing to a person with whom we are well acquainted with, the address might already be known to them. So we are not very keen on the elements of the address as much as it is for the formal letter. But again, it will be good if we can give it in detail. We write the date in whichever format we like, and then the receiver's address is not there in the informal letter. We generally write it on the top of the envelope or on top of the inland on which we are writing the letter. So the receiver's address is not a part of the informal letter. We don't use a subject line as it is not a very formal letter. We are writing this letter to maintain our relationship, to communicate with a person to whom we already know very well. So it is about knowing each other, what we are doing and all this stuff. So we don't have a subject line here. We directly go to the salutation and we generally use name. If we are writing to friends or to parents, it will be like dear Susan or dear mom or dear dad or whatever. So we are not very formal there also. And then coming to the body, this strict pattern of introduction, content and summarizing and all is not followed. We straight away get into the matter that we want to tell them. We tell them about, probably if you are writing to them about a vacation that you spend in some other place, you will be very excited about it and you will be starting right there. You know what, I had this vacation in this particular place and all. So you don't really have to follow the strict format in an informal letter. You will have a complimentary clause there also, which will be mostly yours lovingly or so. The clause that we use will also be more friendly there. And the signature line is also there, again with less components. You will either sign it or you will just write your name. Your designation and all doesn't matter in an informal letter. So you just sign it so that you end it in a very friendly way, or you just write your name. So when we compare the format of informal letters and formal letters, we can see that the formal letter is more rigid in its pattern. We have to follow each and every step as it is. We cannot really take liberty with the format when we are writing a formal letter. But in the case of informal letter, we follow the format with lesser components and we are a bit more relaxed there. And the tone of the letter is also different in both these type of letters. We said that the informal letter is more relaxed in tone, it is more casual in tone, and it doesn't follow a very strict pattern in the body of the letter. Whereas when it comes to the formal letter, it has to be very precise, it has to be short, it has to be in a very simple language, because you don't know the receiver in person. Whereas in the case of informal letter, even if you are using a bit of a complicated language, you know the person, you know whether that person will be able to understand the language that you are using. They also know you and they know the way you talk. So even when the language is complicated, they might understand what you are trying to tell them. But we cannot take that risk in the case of a formal letter. You have to use very simple language. We cannot use abbreviations which they will not understand. We cannot use short forms of words. We do not use don't, but we have to write do not as we write a formal essay or so. So we need to be very cautious while we are writing a formal letter. I'm sure these details about the formal letters and informal letters were already known to you. So this session was basically an attempt to brush up the things that we already knew. So with this session, or after this session, I hope you will all be able to write appealing letters. Thank you.